Hey, good morning. Let's go over today's trade plan. So in the overnight session, we saw that ES held the previous VPOC and then pushed to a new all-time high, indicating buyers in control and confirming the breakout from yesterday. At this point, heading into the open, we know that on the larger time frames, the buyers can remain in control, but in the short term, ES can still put in a pullback. And considering that, we're trading near the previous all-time high and the current all-time high, entering long just based on location is not going to work. So any longs taken up here at these aggressive prices are really going to be based on momentum. So if you don't have underlying momentum in the market and you're not getting some decent upside readings on the NYC tick, then entering long expecting a continuation is going to be a risky setup. Now, if we get any pullbacks into support where you're getting decent location and the day time frame bias is still bullish, then those are going to be the higher quality and the more conservative trades. So if we get a pullback to 14 half to 16 half, first test, that is still an area that can provide edge, especially if the other markets are still holding up well. The Russell continues to be relatively weak to the S&P, and as long as Russell is not completely failing yesterday's breakout and liquidating down, the markets can simply balance, but in a higher range at higher prices. So on the downside, ES can pull back to 14 half to 16 half, even 09 half to 11 half, and it really would not change the bullish structure of the market. Actually, 09 half to 11 half would be a very good spot to enter long, expecting a move back up into the overnight range and back up into the 14 half, 16 half, and perhaps up towards 1975 and higher. So, in the event that we get a pullback, buyers can still be active on any pullback really into support. 14 half to 16 half is the slightly more aggressive spot for buyers to be active. And if we're seeing some broad market strength and participation from the other markets, then the ES can simply balance above pre-market support. In the event of some weakness in the other markets, we may get a pullback to 09 half, 11 half. That's a spot that buyers can defend. So, we'll look to initiate some trades over there. Below that, we have support at 08 and then finally 04 half to 06 half. Now, if the market is truly strong and we're going to continue making new highs, then ideally we don't want to see the market pulling back beyond 09 half to 11 half, or really 08 at most. So if the market even gets down to 04 half to 06 half, that in itself would actually be a sign of weakness, and strong markets typically don't put in those deep retracements. But if it gets there first test, that's still going to be good location for buyers to step in. But if the market's strong, then we shouldn't really head all the way back down there. And if it's very strong, then we can even hold above 14 half to 16 half and just continue printing new highs. On the upside from the overnight session, we have resistance at 21 half to 23, and beyond that, there is no hard resistance. ES is trading at fresh all-time highs, so there is no reference area or level above 21.23. And in order to time your exits, what you can do is look at the other markets. So you can look at NQ and TF, and as those other markets run into their own resistance zones, you can use that as an idea to time the exit in the S&P. So for example, in the Russell, we had resistance at 1250, then around 1253, and finally 1261 area, is a high volume node and can be resistant. So as the Russell heads into those levels, we can use that to time an exit in the S&P. Still not really looking to short ES here. It's the strongest market. It's trading at fresh all-time highs. And typically, when you're dealing with this kind of situation where ES is the strongest, even if it pulls back, and even if the other markets, put in a deeper pullback, the stronger one won't really pull back as much. So the reward potential usually isn't there. When you're trying to short the strongest market. And for that reason, the focus is going to remain on the long side. It doesn't mean that a short can't set up in real time. If there is, for example, a couple of hours of sideways balance and we're breaking down below it, I mean, that could set up an intraday short, but you just have to be more conservative and more cautious on the short side. Looking over at NQ, we have a HVN at 45.13 that can quite easily get tested this morning, and beyond that, we have some resistance then up at 45.30 to roughly 45.38. And again, as these other markets run into resistance, ES can pull back as well. But given the overall bullish bias, the focus is going to remain on the long side, and we'll be very conservative and cautious on any short setups taken. And also keep in mind that if the market just continues chopping in a range and there is no ideal setup, there is no high quality, high risk reward setup, then it's perfectly okay to just sit one day out and not really force any trade. So if we don't get good location, if it doesn't meet our risk reward criteria and the conditions to really enter that trade, then there is no trade and it's okay. So don't try to press and get involved after a day where we've gone from 92 all the way up to, or sorry, yeah, 2092 all the way up to 21 22 75. So the market's already made a pretty decent run, and today's probably going to be more of a consolidation type day. So for that reason, it doesn't really make sense to get super aggressive. Yesterday was the time to be very aggressive, but today is not that day. So today overall, we're going to be more careful. So those are the main thoughts heading into the open. Let's see if the buy side can overall maintain control and provide us with edge, and we'll take it from there.